The first recorded use of the word hockey dates back to the 13th century and was even depicted in ancient Greece. Today, it's hailed as one of the best team sports in the world. Ewan met up with South African-born pro player Justin Reid Ross.
You're one of the world's top hockey players. When was the first time that you realised that you have some hockey talent?
My father played hockey for South Africa for many years. It seemed to be quite a family talent. My uncle played as well. And when I moved up to Pretoria for the first time, I was about 10 years old. And I was actually a rugby player, didn't want to have anything to do with hockey. But when we moved here, I decided to pick up a stick and try, and I had a lot of encouragement from my father and seemed to have a bit of a talent for it from a young age.
So what is it about the sport that attracted you back then?
Well, I think the biggest thing is the team sport elements. I've always been very interested in playing team sports, and the level of technical skill required to play a sport like hockey is very high. You know, it's a very high intensity sport, and you have to work very long and hard to reach a level to play at international competition.
Tell me a bit about your life outside of hockey.
Generally, my life is hockey at the moment. I live and play professionally overseas in Holland, but when I am home from hockey, I get to spend a bit of time with my family. I do quite a bit of coaching and just, you know, take some time off and spend time with my friends and family.
So you believe in a good balance between sport and your family?
When I was young, I focused very much on my hockey. I made my debut at quite a young age, and I worked hard to make the national team at a young age. But I think I realised quite soon after that there needs to be a balance, and you can't really just focus on one thing. You know, you have to make time for friends, you have to make time for family and socialising.
Justin made his debut in the national green and gold colours at the 2006 Commonwealth Games in Melbourne and never looked back.
Let's talk a bit about the training leading up to a big tournament like the Commonwealth Games or even the Olympics.
Preparation for a tournament like the Olympics starts quite a way in advance. Our program includes gym training, technical sessions, individual sessions, obviously a lot of fitness and speed work, also a lot of power and leg strength work. And then for myself, being a drag flicker specialist skill, I do a lot of upper body work and shoulders, chest, that type of stuff.
Is it preferable to rather train with your team as a whole than training individually?
It's definitely better to train with a team as a whole if possible. You know, it also adds an element of motivation, helps the guys push each other a little bit more. We do lack them a lot, so when we do get together as a national team for training camps, we're normally training twice, three times a day for a period of a week. So very high intensity and a lot of hard work goes into those sessions.
He continuously aims to improve his on-the-ball skills, including dribbling, changing direction and moving with the ball, as well as the delicate balance between attacking play and controlling the ball.
Justin, as a professional hockey player, you travel a lot, you train a lot, you're always on the go. Do you believe in supplements?
I don't think I'd manage to get to full training camps. I don't think a lot of us would manage to get to full training camps without having a little bit of help from supplementation, after sessions, during sessions, even in the evenings before you go to bed, just to, you know, make the legs feel a little bit less heavy the morning after.
What are some of the products that are most important to you?
My key products that I use at the moment are Saito Power. I use that for every training session I have. On match days, I like to use the Epic Turbo, just to give me a little bit of a kick towards the end of the game. 70 minutes of hockey is a bit taxing on the legs. After training sessions and games, I like to use Recover Max. That also just helps the legs feel a little bit better the next day and a little bit more energy when you wake up the next morning.
Would you say that supplementation helped you reach the level that you're at today?
Definitely. I think being an international athlete requires you to be able to perform at your highest level every training session, every game. So without the use of a bit of supplementation, I think it would really be difficult to play at that level consistently.
Justin's long-term goal is to become South Africa's highest goal scorer in international hockey.
I've spoken to a lot of professional sports stars and they all agree that recovery is one of the most important things. What is your take on that?
Definitely. Us as hockey players, we actually do a crazy thing called an ice bath after every training session, which is basically getting the legs up to the hips into freezing cold water for anything between 2 and 10 minutes. Obviously, combining that with a good supplementation afterwards, like a Recover Max or a pure protein with a glutamine, something just to you know, make the next session that much more bearable.
Describe to me the feeling of getting into one of those ice baths.
It's terrible. It's freezing cold. In summer, it's not too bad. Obviously, it's nice and warm outside, so the top of your body keeps nice and warm. In the middle of winter, it's a bit of a challenge to get in there and stay in for a full 10 minutes. Your toes go numb, they start burning a little bit, legs start to burn. Fortunately, after a few minutes, you go completely numb, so you don't really feel much after about 3 or 4 minutes.
This is a simple but effective way to offset the risk of injury after long bouts of training. The freezing water constricts blood vessels and decreases metabolic activity, which reduces swelling and tissue breakdown.
And what is your hope for hockey in South Africa? If you could, would you play here permanently?
If I had the opportunity to play hockey professionally in South Africa, that would be my first choice. I love this country. I love being home. Unfortunately, you know, the level of hockey in South Africa just isn't quite high enough yet. But the team is doing very well at the moment, the men's side in particular, and we're focusing now on qualifying for the London Olympics next year.
Justin lives by the creed, we are what we repeatedly do. Excellence then is not an act, but a habit. Tune in again tomorrow for more, and in the meantime, join the USN SA page on Facebook for inspiration to reach your fitness goals.